Somehow we've ended up at this point in the timeline where not only is it quicker and easier to go out and buy yourself a gaming laptop than to wait for graphics cards to come into stock so you could build yourself a baller PC at home, but it's also cheaper to do so. And in nerd history, that's never been the case. So is it a good idea? That's what we're going to take a look at today. Need a Windows or Office key but don't want to pay retail? MMORC.com has all the best deals and a sweet discount for BPS Customs viewers. Just head over to the site link below and enter code BAN35 for 35% off your order total, meaning you could snag Windows 10 Home for under 10 bucks. Fill out your email and place your order, and then click the extract code button at the top of the page. From there, it's as easy as heading to your Windows activation settings and inputting your shiny new key. For more information, head to MMORC.com or check out the links below. So I have compiled a list of 5 awesome reasons why you would want a gaming laptop and 6 terrible reasons why you would not. And if you want to see more of this kind of content here on the channel, make sure that you hit that subscribe button down below. It's super important, guys, to support the channel if you enjoy my content. Leave a comment down below, hit the like button or any of those things. That would be awesome. Also consider following me on Twitter at @BPS_customs. This is my 2018 Razer Blade. It's got an i7-8750H processor, a GTX 1070 mobile version, 16 gigs of RAM, and 512 gigs of NVMe storage. I wanted to talk about and test using my Blade specifically for this video because it's a few years old. Now, yes, it was pretty high-end when it came out and unfortunately kind of expensive, but now it's middle of the road. And I think a lot of people going out and buying a gaming laptop right now would buy something that's the equivalent to this or likely more powerful. So I spent a good amount of time over the past few days actually playing some games on my laptop just to see what the experience is like instead of doing it on my main editing PC, which is this thing right here. These lists are kind of a reflection of my experiences with my laptop. Now, generally, I don't use it for gaming. I use it for mobile video editing, sure. I also use it for watching YouTube while sitting on the couch. But gaming isn't something that I've really done very much of with it, even though it is a capable machine. And I wanted to make sure that I had the experience of using a gaming laptop like the Blade before making this kind of video, so maybe I could sound a little bit more informed. I'm gonna do this list in an alternating fashion. So you're gonna hear a reason why gaming laptops suck, and then you're gonna hear a reason why gaming laptops are awesome. We're gonna go back and forth until we hit the end of our list. So the very first reason why gaming laptops are terrible and you would not want one is that you're never carrying just the gaming laptop. If the point of your excursion is to go somewhere and game, then you're never just carrying a 15-inch laptop in your backpack. You're carrying likely a giant power brick. You're carrying a mouse. You're carrying headphones. You might even be carrying other things like a controller or a keyboard. At that point, it's almost like carrying a small form factor desktop around with you. Granted, maybe a little more portable than that, but the point remains, you can never really just take your laptop on its own somewhere and expect to have a good gaming experience. It just doesn't work that way. These machines are made to be used with peripherals, just like a desktop is. So if you think that you're just gonna take your laptop to Starbucks and be able to bang out a quick CSGO session, well, that's probably not gonna happen. But on the flip side, and maybe the most important thing right now, is that they're available. You can literally go on Amazon right now, buy a laptop, and be gaming on it tomorrow. There are plenty of listings from multiple different vendors with reasonably spec machines all the way up to super high-end stuff. You could buy a 1050 Ti, or you could buy an RTX 3060. You can actually get yourself a really good gaming experience and a powerful machine without the hassle of having to wait for graphics cards to come back into stock or to pay extra to a scalper or even to have to build a machine yourself. But on the other hand, the screen size of a laptop is not ideal for gaming. This is how my blade looks versus a standard 24-inch monitor. And most monitors that are being sold right now are of the 27-inch variety, meaning that it would look even smaller. The screen real estate that you get sometimes is just not enough, especially if you're playing fast-paced games where you need a wide field of view and you need to be able to see things as they're happening and coming at you. Even if you're playing a slower game that has a lot of really lush scenery and you want to be able to explore that world, doing so on a tiny screen that you kind of have to squint at to see everything is probably not the best either. But we could still talk about the screen and flip it to a positive. Many laptop screens right now are highly color accurate. They come with higher refresh rates and adaptive sync. My Razer Blade, for instance, is a 144Hz 1080p panel, and it looks fantastic. I have no problem doing video edits on it. It's color accurate, and when I want to flip over and play a game, the adaptive sync and high refresh rate actually make for a pretty good experience. But you guys are not going to like this one. The performance of a gaming laptop is not going to match that of a comparably spec'd desktop machine. Most of the time, the reason for this is strictly thermals. PCs using high-end cooling equipment can effectively cool the CPU and the GPU a lot better than a tiny laptop with a few heat pipes and a very loud and annoying fan. As a result, you're going to get your core components running at slower speeds, downclocking to make sure they stay within thermal limits, and you're not going to get that kind of peak performance that you would out of the same components, but in a desktop version. But you know, come to think of it, laptops have come a long way in the past decade. You used to only be able to buy low-end Celerons if you wanted to have any kind of reasonable battery life or any kind of reasonable size to your machine. Now you can buy fully featured AMD laptops or a beastly 8-core Intel editing system in a tiny form factor. These are true computing beasts, especially compared to what we had just a few years ago, when a lot of people were turned off from using laptops simply because they couldn't do the work that they needed to do. So having options like going out and buying a hugely powerful gaming laptop with a processor that will let you use Adobe Premiere effectively, or stepping down to a lower power, lower cost configuration, which will give you extended battery life and likely more portability. But does that choice matter if when you buy a laptop, you are almost locked into that hardware forever? A lot of laptops are not at all upgradable. Many of them even have the memory soldered onto the motherboard for space saving reasons. And if you want to go ahead and buy a low-end laptop and say, well, you know what, in a few years I'll add some memory and some storage, you just can't do that. And basically no laptops out there are allowing you to resocket a new processor or change the graphics card. So whatever configuration you buy now, you're still gonna have in 5 years. And in 5 years, is that laptop gonna be good enough? But let's look at that from a different angle. Laptops generally don't depreciate all that fast, and they do retain some value over time. Even a 5 or 6 year old laptop can pretty easily be sold, and you can find somebody who will be able to use it. Laptops can be traded in, they can be passed down, they can be recycled to other users, and this is good for the earth. It reduces e-waste, and you also have a product that you can use to offset the cost of your future purchases. That's not to say that desktop components can't be treated in the same way, but while you could likely find somebody to pick up your old CPU and GPU, it might be a lot harder to recycle that case or that old power supply or those fans that are completely caked in dust. Laptops as a unit typically are pretty easy to move, and you could just post it up on Craigslist and have some cash in your hand the next day, and the new buyer will have something that they can use for hopefully another little while. Hopefully though, that new user is not gonna use it for its awesome keyboard, because gaming laptops typically don't have those. I've reviewed several laptops on the channel that have mechanical switches, and mechanical keyboard switches suck. Almost every laptop on the market, despite the fact that some of them have good keyboards to type on, have terrible keyboards for gaming. The throws of the keys are extremely shallow, and it's often hard to locate your hand to figure out where the WASD keys are versus the other ones, because a lot of times the keys are very close together and they don't really have a gap in between them. You could pretty easily find your left hand on RDFG instead of WASD, and then while you're trying to figure out what the heck is going on, you're dead. But maybe the way to approach this kind of a purchase then is not to only buy a laptop to game on. You're going to buy it as a multi-purpose device. Maybe you leave your baller gaming setup at home in front of a giant monitor. You have your own keyboard, you have your own mouse, you have your headset and stuff, you leave it all there. And then when you want to head out to class to take some notes, or you want to head to Starbucks to write your novel, you just grab the laptop, throw it in your bag, and that's it. You don't take anything else with you because you don't plan to game on the go. You plan to game at home, but need one device that can do everything. So when you get home, chuck it in a docking station and go to work fragging some noobs. And the last thing I want to discuss about gaming laptops and what you should know is that they get super hot and they get super loud. Those fans are going to ramp up to try to keep those components as cool as possible, meaning that there's going to be a crazy amount of noise coming out of that tiny machine if you're really pushing it hard. This could be disturbing to people around you, and it means that you basically have to be using headphones if you don't want to subject your own ears to that kind of torture. Also, the bottoms of these laptops basically act as heat sinks for the components, and as such, they get really hot. You could pretty easily get burns on your legs if you are using your laptop on your lap and doing something that's pretty intense. So what do you guys think of gaming laptops just like this? Is this something that you'd be interested in as a replacement for desktop components that you basically can't get right now? Or are there too many restrictions on their use that would mean that it's not really viable for you? Let me know down below in the comments. Also, don't forget, get subscribed to the channel if you like this kind of stuff. Follow me on Twitter, hit that like button, do all the YouTube things. I appreciate you guys watching, and I hope to see you next time.